My name is John Grimsmo. I'm here at Tormach teaching the class CNC Knifemaking. And at home near Toronto, I've got a shop at home. My brother and I work, and we make custom pocket knives and have a Knifemaking Tuesdays video series. And we have a lot of fun playing on Tormach machinery, and we're just big machining nerds. Over the past few months, I've been developing the knife specifically for this class. It's called the Tor, partially because of Tormach. So I designed the knife so that we can make it completely on the machinery in the class and within the time frame of a classroom environment, like 3 days.
He said that he had been talking about the class and how he's preparing for it for about a month, but I didn't realize Tormach was a Wisconsin company. So when I realized the class was in Wisconsin, I was like, what? I gotta go!
Noticed the knife making class. And
we both like knives.
Ran into his office and said, you want to do this?
And now you're in Wisconsin.
We're here.
Looking good.
Once we arrived at the class, I had conversed with some of the other students online through YouTube. They've seen my videos. They've been following me for a while. And even prior to thinking of the class, I've been talking with these people. So having them come to the class has just been a great experience in getting to meet them and see the kind of things that they're interested in making.
My background is from the restaurant business and cooking, and this was an opportunity for me to kind of take a new tack in my life.
I did get interested in knives just by researching ice boat runners because there's a lot in common.
I'm starting out doing kitchen knives because I love cooking, and that's always something I've been into. So, and they're, you know, relatively easy to make in larger quantities.
The past month or so while I was designing the Tor and figuring it out for the class, you know, I've got this idea in my head of how it's going to run. And you get here and of course things are different and the materials are different or the tools are different or whatever. So we've had to make some changes as we went along, but, you know, as we make a mistake, it was actually really good for the students to see that mistake and learn from it and see how we fixed it. I've never taught a class before, except for I've taught my brother how to machine, you know, once he moved to our location and started working for me, so I taught him, but other than that, I've got no experience, you know, teaching a class of people. But what really surprised me about the class was by the second and especially the third day, I was more hands-off because the students were teaching each other how to run the machinery. Like, I taught the first guy, maybe the second guy, but then those guys had it figured out, and they were helping out future students. And I've heard that teaching is one of the best ways to learn and really enforce something, so having the students kind of teach each other was just a really amazing sight, you know.
You know, obviously, I know some things that other people don't. They know things I don't. Like, I work as a knife sharpener professionally, so, you know, I have a lot of experience in that field, and I'm one of the only guys here that has experience making knives by hand. So yeah, I did find that, you know, I learned from other students, they learned from me, you know, we learned from the teachers learned from us, and it was just a really great experience overall.
I'd never made a knife before, and this class worked me from the very first a billet of water jet cut steel through the soft milling process, through heat treating, hard milling, putting an edge on it, making a handle from G10, seeing the computer design, getting to work with John and Erik, learning a lot about both the machine and about knife making in general. It is exactly what I anticipated, and you know, I had never made a knife before. I'm going home with this beauty. I'm very, very happy.
Erik and John, you know, they did a nice job with the knife and coming in and showing us the different steps. It's not really often that you get the opportunity to, you know, heat treat a blade you just finished cutting and then go put a nice sharp edge on it, and, you know, those are some things that you don't get to do every day, and the experience it gave us will give us a lot more confidence to go back and work on Tony's machine and do some of our own projects.
I plan on filing as a business relatively soon here, and because it's definitely what I want to do for the rest of my life, make knives.
And we're actually converting a small guest residence on our property into a metal shop, and we're going to go ahead and instead of getting back into the restaurant business and being away from my son as much as that requires, I'm going to take a crack at knife making. And one of the things that I like about the PCNC is that you can also make tools or toys or puzzles for my son and do some stuff that's real, things that you can hold in your hand. Because, I mean, I love to make things with my hands, but all of it's food and it kind of goes. You know, people enjoy it, but it's a memory. And so this is a thing that I'm taking this as a new path towards the next chunk of my life, and I'm really excited about it. I took a couple of pictures of the knife once we put it together, and one of my friends that I sent it to, he's like, "Dude, this may be history." And I was like, it's certainly I'm not going to say it's history, but it's certainly a new beginning for me, and it's very, very exciting.
The experience has just been wonderful, and I think the class was received really well, and everybody had a really, really fun time.